Forget it. I know the ones here, they are still fine. Forget about the ones that are here because they have destroyed themselves. But just take it one, go and parade yourself on the streets of Benin and see beauty. And see beauty. But there are people the devil has employed who are going around telling them that the best way to make it is to come to Europe and sell themselves. They don't want to do that. They take them to the shrine and remove all their very important parts. Make them to be naked before the shrine. To swear all sort of nonsense. What a ridicule. What a way the devil is using to ridicule you. Praise the Lord. And many of us agree to follow them and do this nonsense. Well, I'll give God the glory today. Many of you, your eyes are open now. Amen. Praise the Lord. As I'm continuing to say, I stand here any day, any time, any of you is ready. If you have any friend and they are ready to leave the street, tell them to come and see me. Even though there are people with guns, even though there are people with cutlasses, even though there are people with machetes here and there who are threatening, I am not among those who will be afraid of them. They know my shop, let them come and meet me. They know my house, let them come and meet me. I will never be afraid of them. I'm only afraid of them that will kill me, my body, and my soul. Not that that will kill my body and cannot kill my soul. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Some keep running here and there. Oh, Pastor Kingsley is an informant. I'm not only an informant. I will go to the court. I will go to the tribunal to tell the judge, please put this person in jail for what he's doing to my people. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Informant is too small for me. What is informant? Should I be afraid of you that I will be hiding to go and inform police? I don't. I will tell it to your face. If you refuse to stop what you are doing, then be ready to go to jail. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord. Somebody.
Hallelujah.
Anyone who tells you that the best job for you to do is to sell yourself does not like you. And it's a message from the feet of heaven. Hallelujah.
Amen.
It's because of my likeness for you. In this part of the world, there is a lot of opportunities. If only you can just sit down, put your hands together, and do the right thing, you will get there. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
I listened to somebody recently. He said, God loves prostitutes. Even Jesus, it was a prostitute that went to use his perfume. Very costly to have been sprayed on Jesus and use his head. And use her head to begin to. Where is that one in the Bible? Hallelujah.
Amen.
The only woman who sprayed Jesus perfume and used her head to begin. The Bible did not say she was a prostitute for God's sake. Whenever Jesus comes with sinners, Jesus had encounters with sinners. In the Bible, on several occasions, he had a encounter with sinners. He always tell them, go and see no more. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So if anybody is encouraging you for what you are doing, if somebody will even tell you, drink water, let me wash that person so that you have more men, that person is from the pit of hell. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Tell somebody that person is from the pit of hell.
Person is from the pit of hell.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
That is the message from the pit of hell. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
If you read your Bible, I want us to read our 1 Corinthians chapter 6. 1 Corinthians chapter 6. We're not even supposed to associate with prostitutes. 1 Corinthians chapter 6. The Bible has described it. The Bible condemns it. We are going to read from verse 13. 1 Corinthians chapter 6, Are we there?
Yeah.
He said, food for the stomach, and the stomach for food. But God will destroy them both. The body is not made for sexual immorality, but for the Lord, and the Lord for the body. By his power, God raised the Lord from the dead. And he will raise us also. Do you not know that your bodies are members of Christ himself? Shall I then take the members of Christ and unite them with the prostitute? Never. Hallelujah.
Amen.
The body of Christ. Uniting them with prostitutes? No. That is why in this church, prostitutes are welcome, but they are discouraged from continuing what they are doing. Amen.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
They cannot go together. The children of God and prostitutes cannot walk together. It is not possible. Because the children of God are children of life, and prostitutes are children of darkness. And for the past and ever, do you not know that he who unites himself with a prostitute is one with her in body? For it is said, the two will become one flesh. But he who unites himself with the Lord is one with him in the spirit. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
If you unite yourself with a prostitute, you are going to have one flesh. And anything more that is stopping that prostitute will disturb you. That's why some people after sleeping with prostitutes, they say, I know this, somebody came to the show and they said, for 3 days now I cannot sleep. I said, I asked him, I said, where did you go? Where did you share your body? He said, I know your partner, I don't need to share your body. Where did you share your body? You can't sleep. For so many years, I cannot imagine myself not being able to sleep. For what then? Who will go find me? Who will go sleep near me? Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Many of us sleeping with prostitutes and invited demons. As demons are not sleeping with us, at night they disturb us because that is the time of their operations. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Our brother was notified just that he said it. He said, everything changes at night at the school. When time is to be changed, they change it at midnight. Amen. When the day wants to move to the next day, he changes at night. Everything that has to change at night. That's why it's also good when you want to pray for change, let it be at night. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise the mighty Jesus.
Hallelujah.
So, like we were saying, let us not have anything to do. Let us not support anything that will take our guests to the street. If you do so and you are here, you are enemy of Christ. You are either for Christ or you are against Christ. If you encourage anybody or you see any girl still going to the street, every day you go to my car, I like your dress, you fight too much. You are praising her for what she's doing. You are against Christ. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Every single opportunity we have, we must use it to bring them out of the street. Because God is going to ask us. I want you to know that there used to be slave trade. And people stood. People walked. People said no to this. And today, slave trade is illegal. If in our own time, there is a new system of slave trade, and we are watching, I say, it will not concern me. One day it will concern you. One day it will concern you. The day people will start to look at your children on the street, the near father they come from Nigeria, they believe that all this man are prostitute. Whereas they don't even know what is called prostitution. Then you will know it concerns you. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah, somebody. Another message from the pit of hell. Is this what that many of us are able to believe in? Because they believe that the dead do bite. I watched a video recently posted on my Facebook. a sister died, was killed on the street. See, because it has not happened around us, we think it is all rosy. People are dying daily as a result of prostitution. A very young girl died, and they were buried, they buried the girl here in Europe, and they posted this also on Facebook. Why they were all crying and wailing when she was to be buried? Some people threw cake on top of the coffin. I said, use this cake to flog whoever killed you. Some in that place, some they put cutlass in their hand and say, use this cutlass to shoot that person. The guy was saying, if the person is drinking, flog him. If the person is sleeping, flog him. If the person is walking, flog him. Hallelujah. Oh my God. Can the dead bite? Praise the Lord.
Amen.
I was just watching, I was laughing. I said, oh my God, what an ignorance. Amen.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
People like myself say, it is appointed to a man to die once. And after that is judgment. After that is judgment. That person you are putting there, that knife go rotting for them. Go and open that grave in less 3 months, 4 months, that cane don't rot in. Hallelujah. Thank God for Europe. When they are buried, they seal the box. That is the use name to lay everything around. So the first question is, I don't know if you come and go take cane then. Unlike our own in Africa, they will open it. And the person will face up and they put everything in their hands. But I don't see, they don't put contact at all for people. I never see anybody where they take the contact. That's the message from the pit of hell. Hallelujah. Let's not believe that, oh, this person is going to, he's going to kill. He's going to revenge. He's going to do this. And that, when my mother's husband died, my mother was made to pass through a lot. She swore so many things, did so many things, even they petted the dead body and gave her the water to drink. I wanted to fight, but they said, no, it's tradition. And when they were to bury the man, he had not contain anything again. Cutlass did there, knife did there, everything. Of the man's hand. Brothers and sisters, the dead don't bite. Once we die, we are faced with God for judgment. Hallelujah. There's no way the dead man will begin to run. It is out of our imagination that we there will see spirit in the carrying of last day for you. Hallelujah. Demons can capitalize on that, but it's not that dead person. How dead does it is finished? Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. I saw a situation whereby the woman was killed by a second woman who wanted to come into the house. And when the family wanted to bury, they said, you must revenge your this person, you must kill him. As I talk to you, so this person is still enjoying her life. The person will know that, no, mother, this is not, I didn't kill for you then. That was 2004. This is 10 years. The woman went, they said, make the kids, she thought they drive the even bigger cars, they enjoy the cruise with the husband. Hallelujah. So let me tell you, dead people don't bite. So that's the message from the pit of hell. If anybody should tell you that, hey, don't worry, you go fight back, it's a lie. It is not from the Bible. Praise the Lord.
Yeah.
Praise the mighty Jesus.
Yeah.
Because of our time, We will look at the others. Maybe just speak, because I will not say all. Because we have reincarnation. We have also those who talk about purgatory. We also have this message of a single mother who is saying, if you're not a single mother, you're not female couple here. We have so many who also add salt and pepper to testimony. Salt and pepper testimony. What is God going to do? What is God doing? I just read the idea that God just born like this.
Package
us.
Don't miss it.
Package testimony is a message for the people of heaven. Don't add or subtract to what God has done. Let your yes be yes and your no be
no.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Most of us, many who leave the church out of provocation, it's a message for the people of heaven, because the Bible says, when you have problem with one another, settle it. If you cannot take it to the leaders, let there be settlement. Why is it that somebody will not offend you, you run away from the church? It's a message for the people of heaven. Hallelujah. Because wherever you are going, you are also going to meet this same problem there. Hallelujah.
Amen.
I also have those who say end time will never come. Such a message for the people of heaven. So we will tell of all this. And there are also many who say, don't marry a self-dependent, you don't get belay. Give up belay first before you go pay down. It's a message for the peace of heaven. We're going to dwell on all this. And there are also many who turn rebuking to become judgment. When you rebuke somebody, the Bible told us to rebuke ourselves.
Wow.
When you rebuke somebody, you are encouraging that person. But today, when we rebuke somebody, it becomes the judgment. We are going to be looking at the difference between rebuking and judging. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So all this we are going to treat next Sunday. And I believe that the good Lord will be with you. Thank you for the other hand of the people. This song has been in me since morning. I don't know why. This morning, even when I was taking my bath, the morning the song was ringing. I don't know the meaning of that song, but I really love to know the name. Chineke na ide wo. What?
Just thanking God.
Thanking God. Onye elu wa. Oh my God. Chineke na ide wo. Onye elu wa. Chineke na ide wo. There are so many messages from the seat of hell that is taking over the lives of people today. You have heard. You are going to pray. Father, every message from the seat of hell that is not sinking into my life, that is not sinking into my head, let the fire begin to consume and destroy them. That I will be able to walk in your way to the end. That I will not be misled. That I will not be misled. Can that be your prayer in the name of Jesus? Open your mouth and pray, open your mouth and pray, open your mouth and pray. Every message from the pit of hell that is taking into your head, that is not trying to talk you out of the way of the Lord, let the fire of God destroy them. Let the fire of God rebuke them. Let the fire of God cancel them. That I might be able to walk in your ways all my life. And I might be able to serve you in spirit and in truth. And I'll be able to love the Lord. And I'll be able to love the Lord. Father, you are magnified. Thank you, Abba Father. Thank you, King of Glory. Thank you, Essence of Glory. Oh, bless the peace of the Lord. She has a lot of glory.
That we will not waste our strength on the things of the world. Help us not to waste our strength on partying every day. Help us not to waste our strength on things we buy, material things. Help us not to waste our strength on the things that will just be for a while. Ancient of Days, help us, Lord, to store up our treasure in heaven in the name of Jesus. Amen. Father, help us to be conscious of where we are going to, Lord, every day of our life. Help us, Lord, to think and renew our faith in you every day of our life. Father, Lord, we are praying, O Lord. Father, you have said in your word that we should unite ourselves with you so that we will be one in the spirit. Father, help us, King of Glory, to unite ourselves with you every day of our life in the name of Jesus. Father, we are praying, O Lord, that we will not be a forgotten issue in our lives in the name of Jesus. Help us that everything that we do in our life, O Lord, that at the end of the day, we give glory to you in the name of Jesus. Father, when the rapture will come, Lord, Father, Lord, do not allow us to be running up and down instead of us to be rapturable, Lord. Father, we are praying, O Lord, that we will sit in heaven in your throne with you, Lord, in the name of Jesus. Father, every distraction that will not allow us to serve you, Lord, this year and every day of our life, Lord, take it away in the name of Jesus. Father, you said we do not have any kind of counsel, any kind of unity with anybody of the world, whether a prostitute, whether a robber, whatever, King of Glory, we are praying, O Lord, that you help us, King of Glory, to go far away from friends that will distract us. Help us to go away from people that will not make us to make heaven, Lord. Father, Lord Almighty, help us not to have any kind of mind of I don't care. Father, Lord Almighty, it does not matter that we will begin to say it does not matter, oh Lord. Father, that it does not matter attitude taken away from us in the name of Jesus. Father, we are praying, oh Lord, that from today we will have a rethink of our life. Help us, King of Glory, to be closer to you in the name of Jesus. Lord, have left your servant, Lord. Father, we pray, oh Lord, that you reveal him in the name of Jesus. More of your power upon his life. More of your strength upon his life. Every plan of the devil and his agents concerning him, oh Lord. Concerning his race, oh Lord. Concerning his preaching, oh Lord. Let him be destroyed by fire in the name of Jesus. Every tongue that wants to rise up against him in judgment, let him be condemned in the name of Jesus. Every guardian of the witches and wizards, or dangerous spirits, Mami Water spirits, Emery spirits concerning him and his ministry, Lord, be destroyed by fire in the name of Jesus. Father, Lord Almighty, no one will cross his life short in the name of Jesus. Father, we pray, oh Lord, that you alone, all the glory return to you. We cover the service with the blood of Jesus and everything we are going to do at this hour in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Lord, for answered prayers. In Jesus' mighty name, we are praying.